we have kept one current carrying coil in external magnetic field. There is a magnetic field created by any source, this red one. We have kept one coil. What is coil? Coil is a wire like this, boundary, going from the boundary, that is coil. We can have it one turn, we can have it many turns, n turns. Okay, but this is the shape. It is not restricted to this shape. If later, if we want, we can assume that it is circular in shape. It may be any shape, but it should have certain area within it. So if the two wires which are very close to each other and there is no area enclosed in that, that will not work as our principle. It will not create any torque. So what we need, a coil which has got width, which has got length. Okay. Now this coil we place in a magnetic field. If there is a magnetic field, say in this particular direction, and we place a coil here and flow current in it. For the sake of any general condition, I assume that they may not be parallel, they may not be perpendicular, they make certain angle alpha with them. This is magnetic field, this is the coil position making angle alpha. If we see it from the side as you are seeing it now, it will appear like this. But if you see it from the top, it will appear like this. This is the diagram. Top view and that is side view. So we have to understand both the ways, because in everything in magnetic we have to imagine three dimensional diagrams. Okay, so we come here and the current flows in it. We will calculate two things. Number one, what is the force experienced by this coil, and number two, what is the torque experienced by this coil, because we know that there are two type of motions. One is linear motion, one is circular motion. For linear motion, we need a force. For circular motion, we need a torque. Okay. So here, first we assume, what is the force on PQ? Force. We will calculate force first. Force on PQ. This is the magnetic field. This is the current, the force is inside. The force is inside here. This is the direction of force inside. I will make it as indicator of inside force. Here, this is inside force on PQ here. Okay. Now, force on this. This is magnetic field and this is the okay, one portion of this which is perpendicular to it will make a force. And what is the plane of magnetic field and current? Answer: this is the plane of magnetic field and current. See, magnetic field and current, then the force is always normal to it. If the current has this direction, it has a component in this direction, magnetic field in this direction, then the force is in this direction. So here we have a force acting downward. That is force on QR. So what is force on PQ? F on PQ. This is equal to I into L into B. I is current flowing in it. Length of this conductor is L and B is the strength of magnetic field. Now, force on, in place of PQ, we take as QR. Force on QR. Force on QR is I into width into B into sine alpha. Okay, this is the force and its direction is downward. Downward. Here it is sine 90 because this is up and this is this way. This angle is exactly 90, but that is not in this case. In this case it is only alpha. Okay, let it be. What will be its force direction? Up. This is inside. So I will mark it here, inside. This is downward. I will mark it here. Now, force on third arm, that is RS. force on RS is equal to ILB, and that is again sine 90, but what is the direction? Here is the B and the current is going down. If the current is going down, the force is outward, and I will write it the force outward. Okay, then force on SP. Okay, this force, this is the magnetic field, and here is the direction of this has a component this way. This is one component, this is one component, this is one component, this is one component. So the component which is perpendicular to B will make a magnetic field. And this will be how much? This will be I into width. This total length is W, width. This is width. This is width. Okay. So this is IWB sine alpha, but its direction, see its direction, it is coming up. So this is going up. These are the four forces acting on the four straight conductors on it. Now all these four conductors are bound to each other. They can apply force on each other. We cannot separate any one. Now see the forces. ILB inside, ILB outside. Cancel each other. They are equal and opposite to the same body. Here if it is working here, here it is working here. Yes. Here it is working on this conductor. What was the direction in this conductor? Coming out. So I should write here, in this conductor it is coming out. Coming out. Coming out. On this conductor, going in at every place it is going in. On this conductor, coming down. On this conductor, the force is up. This is force. Okay, now these forces are equal and opposite, cancel out. And these two forces, this is down, this is up. This is down, this is up, cancel. This is in, this is out, cancel. So what is the net force on it? Net force on coil is zero. Okay, so net force on coil is zero, no linear motion. So remember, answer for this question, what is net force on a current carrying coil in external magnetic field? Mind the word, what is the net force? So answer is net force is zero. Okay, now if net force is zero, is the net torque also zero? Answer is no. Who creates the torque? A couple of force creates the torque. And who is couple of force here? Answer, these two, do they make a couple? This is working down, this is working up. They are linear and cancel out each other. They do not make a couple, because for the couple, what are our conditions? Our conditions are the two forces should be anti-parallel to each other and acting at different points of a single body. Once again, anti-parallel to each other, acting at different point of the same body, their magnitude should be equal and opposite. Okay, so these three conditions we write here for a couple. Two equal and opposite forces having distance between them and acting at different points make a couple of force which creates a torque. These are the conditions. Now, in this coil, there are two equal and opposite forces. One is this and one is this. Let's take these two forces. Having distance between them, two equal and opposite, equal in magnitude. Only these two are equal in magnitude and these two equal are in magnitude. So we will check. Equal? Yes. Opposite, yes. Equal, opposite. Distance between them, there is a distance between them. This force, answer yes. There is difference between them. Acting at different points, yes, there are different points. Make a couple of force. So this will make a couple of force, and this couple of force will create a torque. What is the torque created by a couple of force? We have the formula in mechanics, and that says force into perpendicular distance between the forces. So I will write here, torque is equal to force multiplied by perpendicular distance between the forces. This is formula for torque, multiplication of these two things. Now I want to find out what is the magnitude of this torque. So I must have two forces indicated in a vector diagram. I make it here. This, if you see it from the top, if this is the coil and it has rotated somewhat, and I see it from the top, what do I see? Only this W line, which is QR line. And when you see it from the top, it will be like this. So you see this one line. That is what I have shown here, QR. And what are the forces? On this side, the force is acting inside this way. And when you see it from the top, it will appear like this. Force working here, this. And this I have shown here. This is the force acting on this PQ. And here the force is acting on this. The force is acting this way. And if you see it from the top, this way or this way, the force is acting this way. So this I have shown here. So this is the top view. This helps us to calculate. Now, only coming to the top view, the force on the coil are these two forces, and what is the perpendicular distance between them? Answer, perpendicular distance between them is this force, this distance, QF. So what will be torque here? According to this definition, the torque should be F multiplied by distance. This distance is, let's give it a name, QRC. So this will be QC, the perpendicular distance, QC. Force into QC, this is the torque. Now we will put value here, and this is the important thing you should understand. Force on each conductor we have already calculated. This is ILB. Okay. This is the force calculated. QC, how much is QC? For QC calculation, this QC, this can be calculated with respect to two angles. What is this? If this is, I am telling you, this is the coil. Where is area vector of the coil? It has got a length in this direction. It has got a width in this direction. Then what? This, where is area? This is area. What is direction of the area? So we have done it many times. Direction of the area is this. So if this is X, this is Y, this is Z. If this is X, this is Y, this is Z, whatever it is. But a perpendicular to surface is known as area vector. This is area vector. So how should I draw it? I should draw it normal to this line. So I have drawn it normal to this line. This is 90 degree. So what is this direction representing? This direction is representing area vector of the whole coil. Now this area vector, this is magnetic field. The angle between the two is theta. And this is the important angle for us, because this is angle between area vector and magnetic field. If this is theta, this is alpha. What is alpha? Alpha is 90 minus theta. If this is alpha, how much is this angle? This is 90. This is 90 minus alpha. But 90 minus alpha is theta. So I can say this is theta. Now, if this angle is theta, what is sine theta equal to? So sine theta is equal to perpendicular QC upon QR. So I will mention it here, sine theta is equal to QC upon QR. So what is QC equal to? Sine. What is QC equal to? QR into sine theta. So QC is equal to QR into sine theta. Now, what is this QR equal to? QR. This is equal to width of the coil. So this we can very well write W into sine theta. This is what? QC. And what is QC? QC is perpendicular distance between the two forces which we need here. Between the forces QC. So this force is equal to ILB and force is equal to ILB multiplied by QC. We will write as W sine theta. And this gives you again a formula, which is torque is equal to, see here, length multiplied by width. Length into width into sine theta. What is this formula for? Or let's forget sine theta. First we make only length into width. Length into width for any coil is its area. So this we can write as torque is equal to I area B sine theta. Well, it has come. What is I? Current flowing in the coil. What is A? Area of the coil. What is B? Strength of the external magnetic field. So this is the torque created. Now, if we have number of turns in the coil, here we have 1, 2, 3, 4 n turns. So there will be n torques which will be added together. So total torque will be for n turns. So torque for n turns. So torque for n turns will be n I A B sine theta. Now here theta is angle between vector A and vector B. And what is cross product of vector A and vector B? Cross product. A cross B is equal to AB sine theta. So this torque is a cross product of area and magnetic field. So I will write it here, torque in vector form, n number of turns, scalar quantity, I is a scalar quantity, it is a multiplication of two vector quantity. This is area. This is area vector and this is magnetic field. So, Ni, this is area vector and this is magnetic field. So, this gives us the torque, NiAB. And when we have to write the magnitude, we will write it NiAB sine theta. Please remember both the formulas. These are very much required whenever we study about motors, whenever you study about generators, and anything which is rotating in the magnetic field, whether it is generator or motor or anything, you will need this formula. Okay, so this is the formula for torque created. So what happens if a current carrying coil is placed in a magnetic field? Answer, it experiences a torque. How much is that torque? The torque is NiAB sine theta. When is this torque maximum? And when this is minimum. Okay, so there is a magnetic field and that magnetic field has this direction. It is not moving. Same magnetic field remains. This is moving. Now when this moves, then at any position, is the torque maximum or is the torque minimum? Answer yes, we can find it mathematically. How we can find it mathematically? That this torque has a magnitude NiAB sine theta. So torque will be maximum when sine theta is maximum because this is the variable term. When it rotates, then it is theta which is changing. So based on the sine theta value, we can find out maximum when sine theta is maximum. So this is how much n I a b, and here theta is equal to 90 degrees. When is theta equal to 90 degree? This theta will be 90 degree if you see this is like this and I want to make it this way so that this theta is equal to 90 degree. Where is the coil? This is the coil QR. Coil's width is this. Where is the magnetic field? This is the magnetic field. Both are in the same direction. Both are in the same direction. So we declare here, when coil is in the plane of magnetic field, then torque is maximum. And opposite to this, torque is minimum when theta is equal to 0. And see here, when theta is equal to 0, this is QR, this is QR, this is area vector. We want this angle to be made 0, so I make it 0. How is the coil now? This coil is perpendicular to B. So when coil is perpendicular to B, area vector become parallel to B and theta will be taken as 0. So T will be minimum 0. Theta is equal to 0, and when area vector theta is equal to 0, when coil is normal to B, magnetic field. Okay, so remember, if this is a coil and this is magnetic field, at this situation, how is the torque? Maximum or minimum? Look here and remember. Is theta, who decides theta? Is it deciding theta? You are very much tempted to say the angle between two is 0. Yes, it is 0. But this is not the theta. This is theta. This is area vector. The area vector and this, they are at right angle to each other, and at this time, this is maximum. So make a thumb rule, remember it. When coil is like this, this is maximum. And when coil is like this, at that time, torque is minimum. How much is the torque? 0. If this torque is 0, that means what? That means it is not able to rotate. It will not rotate itself and it will stop like this. So if I place a coil perpendicular to it, flow current in it, it will not rotate because at 90 degree the torque applicable is 0. So we can also call it equilibrium condition. This is equilibrium. Now if I rotate it further, 90 degree more, 180 degree, okay, make it 180 degree, again it will become maximum, but the direction will be opposite to that. So again make it 270, it will be 0 again. So this way you can always find out the value of torque, but you should remember the thumb rule. When the coil is in the plane of magnetic field, maximum. When it is at right angle, torque is 0. Okay, so this is torque on a current carrying coil, which is, and what happens with this torque? Answer, when we apply torque on something like a cycle handle, like a steering, it is trying to rotate. It is trying to rotate. It is applying a force, we call it. It is applying a torque and it wants to rotate. So unless we stop it, unless we apply opposite torque, it will rotate. When we apply torque on a wheel, the wheel rotates. But when we apply an anti-torque with the help of a brake, then the two torque opposite to each other, they balance each other, the wheel stops. Okay, so this is torque due to current. Thank you.